Thank you, Gene. That's mighty fine.
Oh, uncommonly good, uncommonly good.
That was special dedicated to Private W.A. Hidalgo at APO 940 and for the Ordnance Boys at APO 913.
All right, Dogies, I'm glad I ain't from Mississippi, you know it.
Why, what's wrong with Mississippi?
Well, everybody'd think I was a woman-law. I'd be known as Miss Nation. They'd swear I was a woman. I wouldn't want that at all.
Are you still talking about that Tech Nation business?
Huh?
Abner, we've got a program to do here.
Quit interrupting me. Yeah, I want to hear the boys play anyway.
Yeah, we're going to have an awful pretty tune here that so many have requested time and again. Mexicali Rose.
Mexicali Rose, stop crying. I'll come back to you some sunny day. Every night you know that I'll be pining. Every hour a year while I'm away. Dry those big brown eyes and smile, dear. Banish all those tears and please don't sigh. Kiss me once again and hold me. Mexicali Rose, goodbye. Mexicali Rose, I'm leaving. Don't feel blue. Mexicali Rose, stop grieving. I love you. When the dove of love is winged through the blue, all the castles you've been building will come true. Brown eyes and smile, dear. Banish all those tears and please don't sigh. Kiss me once again and hold me. Mexicali Rose, goodbye.
Thank you, Gene. That was Mexicali Rose, played special for Private Edward J. Spicola, an Autry fan somewhere in New Guinea, and for the Melody Roundup fan somewhere in the West Indies. Now then, Gene's going to do something a little different. He's going to sing When the Lights Go On Again.
They're on now, Pop.
Huh?
I say, they're on now.
What's on?
The light. You said he's going to sing When the Lights Went On Again. They're on now.
That's the name of the song he's going to sing. He's going to sing When the Lights Go On Again.
Well, the lights is on now. You're losing your eyesight.
Oh, for goodness sakes, Abner. Quit interrupting us. Go ahead, Gene.
When the lights go on again, all over the world, and the ships come home again, all over the world, and rain or snow is all that may fall from the skies above. A kiss won't mean goodbye, but hello to love. When the lights go on again, all over the world. And the ships will sail again all over the world. Then we'll have time for things like wedding rings, and free hearts will sing when the lights go on again all over the world.
Thank you, Gene. I know you've made a lot of the boys happy with your music.
Yes, sir.
A special L.E. Stevenson, Somewhere in the Blue Pacific. He's one of the boys that wrote in for it.
Well.
And recollect, fellas, any tunes that you'd love to hear or have them play on Melody Roundup, just write to Melody Roundup in care of Special Service, Los Angeles, USA. Thanks a lot, fellas, and we'll see you again.
Amen.
Melody Roundup is produced by the Special Service Division of the War Department of the United States of America. Performance USA, the greatest entertainers in America, is requested by you, the fighting men of the United States Armed Forces throughout the world. Command Performance, presented this week and every week till it's over, over there. Okay there, India, Burma, and China, pop over the top of the world and slip into a front row seat here in Hollywood. As the whole AEF comes home for that international 30 minutes when the stars come out to answer your letters to Command Performance, care of the Special Service Division in Los Angeles. Whenever the navigator looks at the heavens, he looks for the guiding star. Some call it the load star. But navigator or tank buster, get a load of the star who's guiding your big show during this next half hour. Your mistress of ceremonies, lovely Ginny Sims.
A request now from a bunch of CBs at Navy 8035. George, Slick, Three Striper, and Kinky. They say, get Gene Autry on Command Performance or else. Or else we'll be very disappointed. And out in little South Dakota town, a mother says, please have Mr. Autry sing for my handsome sergeant son, Clyde, whom I haven't seen in 3 years. Well, Mother, for your handsome sergeant in the South Pacific, here's another handsome sergeant. Come on out here, Gene Autry. Sergeant Autry, welcome to Command Performance.
Okay, Jenny. And fellas, for Callahan and the gang at APO 827, for Private Vernon Taylor and friends at 954, and for all you cowhands who quit punching cows to punch Hitler out of North Africa, and for all you guys everywhere, here's Eddie and Jimmy Dean and Johnny Bond gathering around to help me out on a brand new tune. I'll be back.
I'll be back, just because I know you'll be here. There is nothing for you to fear while we're apart. I'll be back when the skies are all clear again, and I'll start life anew again with you, sweetheart. There'll be times when I'm lonely, and I'll miss you, I know. But I'll have my dreams of you wherever I go. I love you so. I'll be back when the storm clouds have turned to blue, and you know I'll be true to you, 'cause I know you'll be here. I'll be back,
I'll be back,
just because I know you'll be here. There is nothing for you to fear while we're apart. I'll be back,
I'll be back,
when the skies are all clear again, and I'll start life anew again with you, sweetheart. There'll be times when I'm lonely, and I'll miss you, I know. But I'll have my dreams of you wherever I go. I love you so. I'll be back,
I'll be back,
when the storm clouds have turned to blue, and you know I'll be true to you, 'cause I know you'll be
Gene Autry. Fellas, with the Command Performance Orchestra, it's Gene Autry again with his grand tune, Be Honest With Me.
Be honest with me, dear, whatever you do. Remember your mind, dear, so always be true. Wherever you wander, on land or on sea, if you really love me, be honest with me. My poor heart would break, dear, if you were untrue. Asleep or awake, dear, I dream about you. Oh, you are my darling, you're all that I see. If you really love me, be honest with me. Someday I'll return, dear, and I'll make you my own. And how I will yearn, dear, when I'm all alone. I'll never forget, dear, your sweet memory. If you really love me, be honest with me. Be honest with me, dear. What else do you do? Remember your mind, dear, so always be true. Wherever wherever you wander, on land or on sea. If you really love me, be honest with me.
Well, fellas, before that little man starts turning out the lights, I'd like to ask Frankie Leitner to take charge of the concert grand and...
For Christmas Eels, it's the Gene Autry Show with Johnny Bond, the Cass County Boys, and the Pinafores. Now, here's Gene Autry.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Blitzing and blitzing and all his reindeers pulling on the rain. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. Hang your stockings and say your prayers, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He's got a bag that's filled with toys for boys and girls again. Hear those sleigh bells jingle jangle, oh what a beautiful sight. So jump in bed and cover your head, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He'll come around when chimes ring out, that's Christmas morn again. Peace on earth will come to all if we just follow the light. So let's give thanks to the Lord above, cause Santa Claus comes tonight.
Well, hello there, everybody, and a very Merry Christmas.
We're all mighty glad you folks could be with us to celebrate this special season of the year. Christmas means a lot to most of us, to little boys like Jimmy here, and to us grown-ups, too. It's a time when we have goodwill toward everyone. That's why Christmas seals have become such an important part of the Christmas tradition. You see, when we buy Christmas seals, we're turning our feeling of goodwill toward others into action, helping to preserve one of the greatest gifts of all, our good health. Every Christmas seal you buy is like a little gift to every other American. Our Christmas seal money helps fight that terrible disease, tuberculosis, helps to stop TB from taking its deadly toll. Remember, you help give good health to someone when you buy Christmas seals.
Folks, this is the story of Christmas, the same story of Christmas that's been told for over 2,000 years. But after all, if you're still a kid like me, you never grow tired of hearing it again and again. So, hey, wait a minute. Jimmy?
Yes, Uncle Gene?
I think you'll be able to hear much better if you climb up here on my lap. What do you say, huh?
Ah, that's it. Well, up you come. Now, all set?
All set.
Good. Because here we go.
Once upon a time, oh, many, many years ago, there lived a man named Joseph and his wife, whose name was Mary, and they lived in the city of Galilee.
Rock, Uncle Gene?
Oh, no, Jimmy. I'm afraid it's a little farther away than Crystal Rock. It's clear over on the other side of the world.
Gosh, that's a long ways away, isn't it? Even farther than Granny's house in Chicago?
Yeah, sure is. Much farther. Anyway, one day, Mary and Joseph decided to take a trip, just like you do in the summer with your Uncle Smokey.
Were they going fishing like me and Uncle Smokey do?
Well, no, Jimmy. They were going away for a different reason. They were going into the city to pay their taxes. Mary and Joseph packed all their belongings on their donkey and started off. You see, in those days, people didn't have automobiles.
Did the donkey look like Champion?
Yeah, I guess so, Jimmy. I guess he did, except that maybe his ears were a little longer and his legs a little shorter.
Would he go as fast as Champion?
Oh, I doubt that. You see, he was pretty well loaded down with bundles. Besides, donkeys aren't meant to go as fast as horses. That's why it took Mary and Joseph several days to make their trip. But then finally, one night in the distance, they saw the city of Bethlehem. Jimmy, Mary and Joseph were tired when they got to Bethlehem, so they went to the inn to get a room, but there were no rooms.
I bet if we lived over there, they could have stayed with us, couldn't they, Uncle Jimmy?
Oh, you bet they could.
And they could have put their donkey in our barn, too.
They sure could. But what do you think happened?
What?
Well, sir, just a few nights later, Mary and Joseph became the mother and daddy of a little baby boy. Since they had no place to stay, their little baby boy was born in a manger.
What's a manger, Uncle Jim?
Well, son, a manger is sort of like a trough in a barn. Only this manger was in a cave.
Did it have a hayloft and stalls and everything?
No. No, I'm afraid this one didn't, Jimmy.
How did Miss Mary and Mr. Joseph keep the little baby warm?
Oh, they just bundled him all up in blankets. Of course, his mother stayed close to him, too. But then that first night, a very strange and wonderful thing happened.
What?
Well, sir, at the very same time Mary and Joseph were watching over their baby in the manger, there were lots of shepherds out in the fields guarding their sheep.
What was the wonderful thing that happened?
Well, son, while the shepherds were watching their sheep, they looked up at the sky. And there, right before their very eyes, the sky seemed to get brighter and brighter. And the shepherds were afraid.
Did they think it was going to storm?
They didn't know what to think, Jim.
Gosh, what'd they do?
Well, that's when the wonderful thing happened. All of a sudden, an angel appeared before them and spoke to them.
What's an angel, Uncle Jim?
Well, let's see, son. Remember when you used to get dirty in that mud hole in the back of your house?
Yes.
And then one day you didn't do it anymore?
Uh-huh.
Well, an angel told you not to.
Yes. Is an angel good all the time?
Oh, I should say so, Jimmy.
Can anybody hear an angel, Uncle Jimmy?
You bet they can. All they have to do is listen.
Well, what did the angel say to the shepherds?
The angel told them not to be afraid. That the bright light they saw in the sky meant that a new baby boy had just been born in the city of Bethlehem. A child who'd come to tell them all how to live in peace with each other. A baby boy named Jesus. Jimmy, the shepherds left their sheep and hurried to the manger in the city of Bethlehem to see the new baby Jesus the angel had told them about.
Was the little baby asleep when they got there?
Well, yeah, I guess he was, son. Little babies spend most of their time sleeping.
What did you say his name was, Uncle Jimmy?
Jesus.
Oh, I've heard of him.
Well, I guess almost everybody's heard of him, son. You see, he was a pretty special baby. In fact, he was so special, lots of folks, even kings, brought him presents. But it seems in that day there lived in the land of Judea a king named Herod, who was a bad and jealous king.
Why was he so bad, Uncle Gene?
Oh, I don't really know, Jimmy. I guess he was like a lot of people in the world today. He just didn't know that he could become happier himself by making other folks happy. So he was mean and cruel.
Did he hurt Miss Mary and Mr. Joseph and the baby Jesus?
Well, he might have, Jimmy. That is, if it hadn't been for the angel.
You mean the same angel who talked to the shepherds out in the field?
Mm-hmm, that's right. That very same angel came and talked to Joseph one night while he was sleeping.
But Uncle Gene, how could Mr. Joseph hear what the angel was saying if he was asleep?
Well, he heard him in a dream.
You mean dreams like I have of ponies and carts and cowboys and bucking horses?
Well, something like that, son. Only this dream was a little different. You see, in this dream, the angel told Joseph many things about the little baby Jesus.
What?
Well, for one thing, the angel told him to take Mary and the little baby Jesus and go to Egypt.
Why?
Because the angel said if they didn't, King Herod might come and hurt their baby.
Didn't King Herod like the baby Jesus?
Well, no, Jimmy, I'm afraid he didn't. You see, he too had heard about the baby Jesus. And King Herod was afraid that someday that little baby might grow up and become king instead of him.
Gosh, Uncle Gene, what did Mr. Joseph do?
Well, son, that very same night, Joseph took Mary and the little baby Jesus and went away to Egypt, just as the angel had told him to do.
Well, what happened to the baby Jesus after that?
Well, lots of things have happened to him, Jimmy. And as you grow older, you'll find out more and more about it. But I can tell you this. A lot of people in the world today have forgotten all about him. And because they have, a lot of other people aren't very happy. You know, son, this world of ours is a couple of thousand years older. And it's grown quite a bit since way back when this story first took place. Great and near great men have left their marks on history's pages. Kings, dictators, emperors, and presidents. Some because of the good they brought into the world, others because of the sorrow they left behind. Well, most of them are gone and forgotten now. But that little baby who was born in a manger nearly 2,000 years ago will live forever in the minds and hearts of millions of people who still believe in things like love, hope, understanding, and peace.
Hey, look, Gene. He's gone to sleep.
Yeah, he sure has, Johnny. Yeah, I guess we better put him to bed. Here, hold him while I get up.
Right.
Okay.
I'll take him now.
Let's go.
Golly. I wonder what he's dreaming about.
Oh, probably the same things you dreamed about when you were a kid.
That's so long ago, I wouldn't remember. Mm-hmm. You want me to turn back the cover?
Yeah, Johnny, will you please?
Right.
Okay, in you go, little fella. There. Flip the light off, will you, John?
Got it.
Good night, Jimmy. Merry Christmas. And now, before we say goodbye, let me tell you how you can make your Merry Christmas and Happy New Year wishes have a little more meaning this year. Buy Christmas seals to help fight tuberculosis. Why only wish for good health and happiness for your friends and loved ones when you can do something to help make them come true by buying Christmas seals?
United States Treasury Department presents Guest Star with Frank Duvall and his orchestra, the Cass County Boys and the Pinafores. Yours truly, Del Sharbert, and starring Gene Autry. How do you do, ladies and gentlemen? This is Del Sharbert, your host for Guest Star, a transcribed feature for defense bonds presented by this station as a public service. Improved Series E defense bonds
pay 3% interest compounded semi-annually when held to maturity. Invest more in defense bonds through payroll savings where you work or the bond a month plan where you bank. And now here he is, America's favorite cowboy, Gene Autry.
The bells are ringing for me and my gal. The birds are singing for me and my gal. Everybody's been knowing to a wedding we're going. And for weeks they've been sowing every Susie and Sal. They're congregating for me and my gal. The parson's waiting for me and my gal.
And sometime he's gonna build a little home for two, for three, or four or more.
In Loveland, for me and my gal.
The bells are ringing for me and my little gal. The birds are singing, cause they're jealous of me and my gal.
Everybody's been knowing to a wedding they're going. And for weeks they've been sowing. Every Susie and Sal, they're congregating for me and my gal. The parson's waiting for me and my gal.
And sometime he's gonna build a little home for two, for three, or four or more.
In Loveland,
for me and my gal.
That was Gene Autry opening the show with For Me and My Gal. And a great rendition it was, too. How about another of your favorites, Gene?
Glad to oblige, Del. Here's one that's been a favorite of folks the country over for many a year. It goes like this.
Out in the valley.
Wonderful, Gene. Well, now, how's about joining me with a few words on my favorite topic?
You mean defense bonds? That's my favorite topic, too, Del. Also, my favorite way of saving.
You've got company there. It's the favorite of millions.
Yes, Dell, I know that millions of people buy bonds every payday through the payroll savings plan, and it's great. But my favorite method is the bond-a-month plan.
Yes, the bond-a-month plan is made to order for professional men and women and those who are in business for themselves. It gives them the same opportunity for systematic saving that payroll savings gives to salaried workers. Suppose you tell our listeners how it works.
It's very simple, ladies and gentlemen. You just authorize your bank to buy a bond for you every month and charge it to your checking account. From there on, it's automatic. You make the resolution, but your bank carries it out for you. So, if you're self-employed, why not ask your banker about the bond-a-month plan? And just one more word. Remember that when you buy defense bonds, you're investing in your country's defense as well as in your own future security. Believe me, there's no better investment in the world.
Thank you, Gene Autry. And now let's get along with another song. The Cass County Boys and the Pinafores singing that old favorite, Lazy River.
Lazy river where the robin song awakes a bright new morning, we can loaf along.
Blue skies up above,
everyone's in love.
Up the lazy river, how happy you can be.
Up the lazy river with me,
let's all go.
Up the lazy river. Troubles, dream a dreaming with me.
Up the lazy river where the robin song awakes a bright new morning, we can loaf along.
Blue skies up above, everyone's in love. Up the lazy river,
how happy we could be.
That was wonderful. Well, now, while you take a short breather, here's Frank Duvall and his orchestra with a wonderful rendition of Bury Me Not on the Lone Prairie.
Thank you.
Thank you, Frank DeVoe. Once again, our star Gene Autry returns to the guest star microphone with
South of the Border, down Mexico Way. That's where I fell in love when the stars above came out to play. And now as I wander, my thoughts ever stray south of the border, down Mexico Way. She was a picture in old Spanish lace, and for a tender while I kissed a smile upon her face. For it was fiesta and we were so gay south of the border, down Mexico Way. Then she sighed as she whispered mañana, never dreaming that we were parting. And I lied as I whispered mañana, for our tomorrow never came. South of the border, I rode back one day. There in a veil of white, by candlelight, she knelt to pray. But the mission bells told me that I mustn't stay. South of the border, down Mexico Way.
Quarter hour, you've been listening to Guest Star, a transcribed program for defense bonds presented by this station each week as a public service. May I express our thanks to our star, Gene Autry, and to Frank Duvall and his orchestra, the Cass County Boys and the Pinafores, for a fine show. We'll have another famous guest on hand next week, so I hope you'll join us. Meanwhile, this is Del Sharbert saying so long and suggesting that you sign up for systematic saving through the payroll savings plan where you work or the bond a month plan where you bank, for the regular purchase of United States defense bonds.
Let's hit the trail to the Old West to Melody Ranch with Gene Autry.
I'm back in the saddle again. A friend is a friend. Where the longhorn cattle feed on the lowly gentle weed, I'm back in the saddle again.
Howdy, folks. Your friendly local merchant who displays and sells healthful, refreshing, delicious double mint gum brings you the romance and melody of the Old West and the true life military drama. The doings at Melody Ranch reach you today through Columbia's facilities in the nation's capital. And here is your host, that range roaming rancher, that gun-slinging, song-singing son of the West, Republic Pictures' great cowboy star, Gene Autry.
Fetch me down my shooting iron, I'm a-going hot. Fetch me down my trusty 45. See the fire in my eye, watch the smoke when I go by. Fetch me down my trusty 45. I used to call my cows with a whistle.
used to call my dog with a horn. Harmonica is the thing to wake the chickens. Let the rooster sleep late at morn. I used to have a 12-calling system. Blew until I ran out of breath. A hillbilly band from the city run all of my animals to death. Fetch me down my shooting line, I'm a-going hunting. Fetch me down my trusty 45. See the fire in my eye, watch the smoke when I go by. Fetch me down my trusty 45. They had a guy that played on the fiddle. Played bring my lover back to me. Never in all my days she forget me. Those hillbilly fellas play for me. One play coming around the mountain. Looks like it beat off his ears. They may like your noise in the city. We ain't going to let you play it here. Fetch me down my shooting line, I'm going hunting. Fetch me down my trusty 45. See the fire in my eye, watch the smoke as I...